Here's some of the shortcuts you're about to learn, and we'll use this messy sheet on Excel as the example. Firstly, we'll write the emails for each country manager, and for that we can just use the flash fill function. Secondly, we're gonna refill everything so it's more pleasing to the eye. Then thirdly, we're gonna do an auto sum to fill the totals for the year. And lastly, we're gonna rearrange the titles a little bit, so make them bold and put an underlined border on it. What's up everyone, it's Kenji here, and today I thought I'd go over some of the most useful Excel shortcuts. Specifically, they're going to be for people either in business or finance fields, whether that be as a student or a full-time working professional. And you can download the file I'll be working with for free, as I'll link it in the description as a Google Sheets. Now, if you want to edit it, you can go on File, Download, Microsoft Excel, so you can follow along. And if this video does well, I'm considering doing a part 2, so make sure you hit that like and that subscribe down below. Alright, let's get into it. And thank you to Financial Edge for sponsoring a part of this video. So the first type of shortcut we'll be looking at is navigation. So moving around datasets like this one we have here with the GDP growth of each country. So to move to the bottom of a dataset, instead of going one by one pressing the down arrow, you can press Control down arrow to go all the way down, Control down arrow again to go all the way down to the end of Excel, Control up arrow to go all the way back up, Control right arrow to go right and left obviously, and then all the way back to the other side. So the Control key is gonna expedite that whole process for you. Now if you want to navigate while selecting everything in the dataset, you can do Control shift and then the arrow keys, so arrow down, arrow to the side, then arrow down to get everything. Now if you want to deselect a specific area, just remove the Control key, so shift arrow, and that should let you select whatever area you want in particular. Now if you want to select a particular column like this one with the country names, you can do Control space. If you want to add a column to that, you just do Control plus from there, Control plus again, Control minus to delete some. Similarly, if let's say we want to add a row over this one, firstly we'll select it by pressing shift space and then Control plus to add some, Control plus, Control minus to delete some as well. So if you want to hide a particular column, first you press Control space and from there you press Control 0 and that should hide it. Now you can see between A and C the B is no longer there. Now if you look closely into the area and then double click it there, you're gonna see that it comes back out. Now the shortcut to unhide a column is actually Control shift 0. I will say that sometimes that doesn't work. If that's the case, you can try Alt OCU and that should open it up for you. So for rows, it's quite a similar process. Firstly, to select it, we'll press shift space and then from there you'll press the Control 9 and that should hide it for you. You can see the number 2 is no longer there. Now if you want to open it up, you can obviously double click it again, but the other way to go about it is to press Control shift 9. And you might wonder why it's necessary to be hiding rows or columns, and that's a fair point. It usually has to do with assumptions. For example, if you're presenting to a management team, and you don't necessarily want to be showing all of those assumptions that you've made, you would just hide them. But do be careful with this, especially if somebody new comes into a model and doesn't know that there's hidden cells in there, it can obviously be very frustrating for them. Instead, what I think is a better option is grouping, so let's look into that. So suppose we want to hide the 2012, 13 and 14 years, so for that we'll select them by pressing Control space and then shift arrow again. And now we'll press shift, alt and then right arrow to make a group, and you can see that there's a selection up here. Now you can close it and open it, and it's obviously a lot more visible that there is something hidden in there as opposed to just hiding it without telling anyone. Now in case you want to remove it, for that you'll just press the alt shift and left arrow to remove it, alt shift right to add it and remove again. Another useful way to highlight an assumption is to use the note feature, so let's look into that. The shortcut for that is actually just shift F2, and here you can write whatever you want obviously, and you can see that it's gonna remain there in red. It is noticeable but good enough that you can see the other data. Now if you want to navigate between the different sheets you have down here, you can press the Control up and down. Lastly, if you want to copy a whole sheet, like let's say we want to double that navigation sheet, you can press the Control and then just drag it along to the other side. And there you go, you have the double. Alright, so moving on to inputting data, and we're gonna be using this table over here, so that's the second sheet on inputs with some output products and some information about them. But first, let's talk about the sponsor of today's video, Financial Edge. So if you're interested in learning more about Excel, I definitely recommend you check out Financial Edge's certified online finance courses. They're the instructors that teach the new hires at the top 4 investment banks, so you can get the exact same training online at your own pace. For example, their Business Toolkit course pack goes over all the relevant skills to become more efficient in the workplace using Microsoft Office, from financial modeling in Excel all the way to creating professional decks in PowerPoint and presenting them effectively. They've also got plenty of other relevant courses for those interested in careers in business or finance, like investment banking, asset management, private equity, and much more. So if you're interested, check out the link in the description below to get 25% off by using code KENJI25. Alright, back to the video. So starting off with the very basics, if you want to copy something, Control C, if you want to paste it, Control V. Now if you want to copy this entire table instead of just one cell, what you can do is press Control A to select it all. If you press Control A again, it selects the whole actual Excel sheet, but in this case we just want the table here, so press Control A once, then Control C, and just Control V over here. If you want to go back, you can just press the Control Z button, Control Z again to delete all of that. Some of the other very common ones include Control B, which is just going to bolden something, Control U to underline it, and then Control I to italicize. You can press them again if you want to remove it, or you can also press Control Z. Now sometimes when you copy and paste something, you don't necessarily want the same formatting, so for that you can use the paste special. So let's say we want to copy this revenue cell, but we don't want to copy the same formatting. If you press Control V usually, it's gonna give you the same formatting, but we don't want that. So let's press Control Z for now. And what we're gonna do is press the Control Alt V instead. And what you're gonna see here is a paste special tab. And in it, you have different pasting formats that you can use, like formulas only, values only, or formats, etc. In this case, let's say we want the value and not the same format. So we'll press the down arrow to the values and press Enter. And now we don't have the blue formatting, and instead we only have the values in it. So let's press Control Z to go back. Now you can see that this one's selected, just press Escape if you want to deselect it. Now to actually get into the cell, let's say we want to write revenue total instead of just revenue. When I put total in there, it deletes whatever I had previously, which is quite annoying. Press Escape to take that out. So instead what you want to do is press the F2 key, which is going to let you get inside the cell. So revenue total, we can just write it in here now. Now if you press F2 again to navigate within the cell instead of having to press the arrow keys like that, you can press the Control arrow to skip to specific words, Control Shift arrow to actually highlight specific areas, Control A to select everything, and so on. Now moving on to the bottom of the table here, suppose we know that the next products are all gonna be Apple, so we're gonna press the Control D once we're here, and you can see that that just copies whatever you had above. So in mouse, it's gonna press mouse, Hong Kong, and so on. That's the Control D button. If you want to fill to the right instead, so you can press the Control R, Hong Kong, Hong Kong, Hong Kong. Now suppose you want to write something longer for Hong Kong. One thing you'll notice is that the cell just continues on, but what if you'd like it to be two lines within that same cell? For that you'll press the F2 key, and then we'll press Control arrow to get over here, and then you're gonna press the Alt Enter. That's gonna make it all within that one cell. Now moving on to formatting data, and for that go to the third sheet that's titled formatting, and you can see that we have this whole table here that's completely unformatted. Now one of the common ways to go about formatting is to press the Control 1 key. That's going to give you all of the different options that you have for formatting, from numbers to alignments to fonts and so on and so forth, and you can press the Control Tab key to navigate between them. I personally don't really like to use this one, so you can press the Escape. What I prefer is to actually use the Alt key. So if you press Alt once, you'll notice that there's all these letters that come up on the top of the ribbon. So you press Alt H and the more letters come up, but these are basically all the shortcuts that you can do. So you can see that one is for the B here for bold. So you press one there and it's gonna make the company bold. Press Control Z to remove that. So let's try to format this using the Alt key and make it a bit prettier. So for that, we'll just press the Control Shift and right arrow to select the titles. You can either press Control B, which is a shortcut we learned earlier for the bold, but let's use the Alt ones for now. So we'll press the Alt H 1, and that's gonna make it bold. And you can see that there's actually many different ways to go about shortcuts. This is just one of them. And then you'll press Alt H B for border, and then bottom border, let's say. So we'll press O for that, or you can also do all borders by pressing A. Let's do A instead. Then once we have that, let's select them again, Control Shift arrow. And then we'll fill them in a blue color, for instance. So Alt H, H, and blue. So we're gonna just, with the arrows, go to the blue one that we like. And then here, let's say that we don't like that the price and the revenue are not in dollar signs, so let's change that. So we'll press Control Shift down arrow, and then Shift right arrow to select both areas. And then we'll press Alt H, AN, and then press Enter. And that's gonna give us US dollars. Now you can see that there's actually two more decimals than we would like, so we'll press Alt H9, Alt H9 again, and that's going to remove the decimals for us. Now doing these formatting shortcuts for the first time, you might notice that you're actually quite slow, and that's perfectly normal. Maybe you're even faster using a mouse, but if you invest enough time in them, you start to memorize them, and it's definitely gonna make you a lot faster in the long run. Another thing you'll notice here is this Format Painter button. You can select that obviously by clicking on it, or you can press the Alt-H FP, and you can see that this cell is now selected. And if, for instance, we go on this one, the I one here, and we click it, you'll notice that the same formatting appears on this one. So it essentially copies any format. So let's say we want to copy the dollar format to the quantity over here, we'll press the Alt-H FP, and then just select this one here. Now let's move on to the next sheet by pressing the Control Page Down button. So once you're here, you'll notice that it's a complete mess. All of the columns or rows are in inconsistent lengths. So you can either go one by one and actually change them, or there's actually a better way to go about it. So you press the Control A key, and then you'll do Alt H O, and then the I here is going to give you the autofit column width. So first we'll do the columns, and then we'll press Alt H O A for the row. And there you go, it's looking a lot better now. All right, moving on to shortcut formulas. And for that, we'll be using the formulas sheet. And we have this information here on Apple products sold by the A team, which consists of these people over here. So let's say we want to find the sum of whatever they sold in 2018. So for that, you can either do the equals sum formula, which is the way that most people go about it, and then you'd select everything that you need and press enter. But let me delete that quickly. The shortcut for that is the Alt arrow key. That's just going to select everything and do it quickly for you. If you want to take it a step further, let's say we want to select all of these years, you can just select them first by pressing the Shift arrow key. And then from there, you just have to press the Alt equals and you'll get all of them at once. Same thing applies over to the horizontal side. It's smart enough to calculate that as well. Just press the Alt equals again. There you go. If you ever want to see what the formula is grabbing, you can press the F2 key and it's going to show you. And the last one I'll go over is flash fill. For that, we'll go over to this other table that we have down here. And first, we want to find the first name of this person. So it's Sam in this case. We'll just type Sam once. And then from there, you can actually just shift down arrow all the way to the bottom and press the Control E. And that's going to fill everything for you. Same thing applies here. So you type Smith once and then shift down arrow and press Control E. Same with the email. So let's say that sam.smith@gmail.com, and assuming all the other users are also Gmail users, you can just shift down arrow and Control E as well. So it is quite smart in that sense. So in this case, we just use the flash fill for the first name, the last name, and the email. But as you can imagine, this formula is actually quite versatile. For example, if there's employees working at the same company, you can use it for that, for country codes, for the first initial numbers of a cell phone, and so on. At some point along the way, maybe you realize that the way you do a shortcut is different to the way I do it, and that's something quite normal. In Excel, there's actually many different ways to go about it. For example, let's say I type 0.33 here and here as well, and we want to change that number into a percentage. I could do Control Shift percentage sign, or alternatively, I could also do Alt HP like we saw earlier. That's all for this video. I hope you found it helpful. If you want more Excel videos, do let me know down in the comments, and hit that like, hit that subscribe, it really helps out, and I'll catch you in the next one.